Okay, let's start. So today I will talk a bit about DevOps, Scrum, MVP, and microservices, and how these methodologies actually are solving the same problem. So briefly about me, 12 years in IT, you know, a bit of operations, a bit of development, DevOps, you know, and classic IT system administration, faithful to the same employer for the past 12 years. And my plan for my career was always to be something called IT generalist. So I never wanted to go very deep into the single technology like networks or Linux or something like that. I was jumping from one technology to another, and this will be relevant to the rest of the presentation. That's why I'm mentioning that. So next 20 minutes, questions at the end, please. There will be a couple of minutes to ask your questions. And three things that I would like to talk about. So when we think about DevOps and all of the stuff, we need to address three different areas. First is value, second is people, and third one is product. So let's start with value. When you think about this one, what everything that you do at work, or you should be doing at work, basically generates a value. Value for other team, value for the company, value for the customer. And from customer perspective, if you divide this value generation process into the bits, the smaller one, you get something called a value stream or value chain. And this is how it looked before the DevOps happened. This is the old school value stream. So there is a team of architects, and they prepare the architecture. Then they pass it to the development team full of developers. They make it happen. Then this guy passes it to the security team. They make it secure. Then it's being tested, and then it's being pushed to the operation teams that push it to the production. This unfortunately has some negative implications. The most important of which is it creates us versus them thinking. And this is totally under, this is not something that we want. Yeah? It also creates thinking, it's not my problem. Yeah, this is classical developer versus operations. Yeah, it works for me. Yeah, that's it. So what DevOps teaches us about this one? DevOps teaches us that this whole value stream, you know, that creates a value for the customer should be owned by a single team. There should be a team that can do their own architecture, development, security, testing, and operations. This is what DevOps teaches us. How does the MVP methodology add to this? Well, MVP teaches us, among other things, that the most important thing is the customer feedback. And based on this feedback, we need to make further decisions to develop our product. So this becomes a cycle. Yeah, this becomes a loop. So you architect something, you develop it, make it secure, test it, put it in the production, reach out to customer for the feedback, and based on this feedback, you start the next cycle. What does the Scrum add to this? Speed. Scrum is quite explicit about this one. Yeah, 2 weeks is what how long this cycle should take. So these are the small iterations, constant customer feedback on based on which we are building the next iteration of our product. And this is the whole value stream that DevOps teaches us about. The next thing that's important is people. How people are affected in DevOps? Well, again, old school approach. We have an architectural team full of experts from architecture area. We have a development team full of development specialists, experts, yeah, doing development, et cetera, et cetera. But as we know, this creates us versus them thinking. So if we poorly implement DevOps, we just take all of these people, put them in the single team, give them the whole value stream to own, and problem fix. Well, not that easy. If you put a developer in this team, the developer will prefer development type of work. Whatever development task will be assigned to this team, the developer will take it. So that's not how it should work according to Scrum, because Scrum teaches us that the responsibility is never on the individual, but it's always on the team. Yeah, this is the team effort. But how can you be responsible when you are a developer for security? How can you be responsible for operations if you are a tester? Yeah, this is not something that's easy for people. So they naturally fall back to this one. Yeah, they select the tasks in this whole value stream that fits them better. So we are missing one important thing. So let me talk about types of IT people in the job market. Past 10, 20 years was all dominated by specialists and experts. I call them I person, yeah, this, because they select single area of expertise and they go very deep. They become experts, you know, the best. So this type of people were driving the whole growth in IT industry for two decades, but not anymore. Today we look more for T person. This is the hottest people on the job market. Yeah. Whenever you hear full stack developer, that's basically T person. Yeah. So T shaped person in a sense that they are specializing in development, maybe not as much as the expert in the previous generation would do, but they still specialize in this. But they know all the wide technology ranges that helps them to be good at these devs. But the future of the job market looks like this. And this is already happening. The next 10 years will look like this. We're looking for comp people, yeah? So you are not becoming expert in this model in anything. You just go as deep as you can in all of the areas. And these people fit perfectly into this model, where you have DevOps with Scrum, where the team owns stuff, and these people are able to take any kind of task from this whole value stream. Of course, they are different. You may be slightly better at development than in operations or vice versa, of course, yeah? But the team has all the skills to perform the work using DevOps approach. Third thing that we need to discuss is product. And from DevOps perspective, there are two types of products. The first one is monolith. Well, what is a monolith? Think about this as a single code base, maybe divided inside some classes, you know, maybe different teams are responsible for different pieces of that, sure. But it's still one big thing to which all other teams somehow add value to. I'll give you an example. Think about a monolith, like imagine you have a Lord of Rings book and you have many authors, and there is one team responsible for Gandalf card. They got in touch with customer, and it seems that customers will like the book much more if the Gandalf will become female character, so they rename him to Gandalfina, and they apply the change across the book. The book is getting released, it's getting published, and it's a complete disaster. Why is it? Because all other teams in their parts of the book, they were referring to the Gandalf as to him. Now they should refer to this person as to her. So it's a total disaster. So what should have been done to prevent this with a monolith? Well, this team should have talked about this with all other teams. They should all meet, collaborate, agree, decide how to do it, if to do it, etc. And that's cool if you have a small monolith, but if you have monoliths where there are hundreds of teams contributing to it, that's impossible. Collaboration becomes enormous. Disadvantage in this case. So the simple change that could get this released in a week actually is being released to the publicity after a year. Yeah? That's the reality of monolith. So the next approach is microservices. So microservices architecture, the important thing about it is to know that it does not solve any technical problems. It adds more complexity, so it adds more potential technical problems. It does not solve any technical problems. What it solves is a development problems. So in this scenario, you have a small bit, small parts of your product that the DevOps approach teams can own. They can develop it independently, how often they want, every day, every year, whatever. It doesn't really matter. And what ties this all together is APIs. These things communicate using API. And this API needs to be sacred. It should never or almost never change. This is the most important fact of microservices. What's the API? API is the interface. I will give you another example. When I go to McDonald's, I go to them and I say, that's my API call, cheeseburger, please. Then they do something, I don't care what, and at the end, I get a cheeseburger. So my API call is cheeseburger, please. And then I expect the result. As long as they don't change this one, so I get a cheeseburger at the end and the API call stays the same, I don't care how they do it. They can redesign kitchen 5 times a day, they can split it into 5, hire robots, hire more people, outsource it, I don't care, yeah? So they have complete independency to develop this small piece. And another thing is that if these guys want to deploy something on production, because that's their responsibility to deploy it on production, some of you may have tried to deploy something on production in the past. So you know this requires a lot of Linux skills, a lot of operational skills, et cetera, et cetera. So if you have this type of people with very shallow but wide skills, how would they do it? Well, that would be very hard for them. So that's the last piece that's actually missing, help. This whole DevOps model does not mean that specialized teams stop existing. They are still there, but they don't own your part of product. So you are responsible and your DevOps team for vision, architecture, and design. But there is still architectural team that will help you, that will guide you. They are not responsible for your architecture. You are, but they are there to help. The same with documentation. You know your product. You are writing it, yeah? So who best will document it? You and your team needs to document it. Of course, you are not specializing in it. So documentation team will give you templates, they will give you tools, they will give you guidance. The same with security. You need to make your product secure. You cannot outsource that, yeah? Other teams, they can help you. They can provide you with a guidance. QA team, the same. And we go to the DevOps team. So this is very often confused with the whole DevOps methodology. DevOps is a methodology. And whenever you hear about someone hiring a DevOps, that's what they mean. That's only just a fraction of the whole DevOps picture. The DevOps teams, they make sure that your tests are automated, that your builds are automated, and that your deployments are automated. Yeah? But they, again, don't own this. You write these tests. You know how to build your product. You know how it should be deployed. So they will help you with tools, expertise, frameworks, whatever, but that's your ownership. And there is a concern that I hear quite often from the developers. If we move to this DevOps model, this means that I will need to also monitor our application. This means long weekends, nights, etc. Yes and no. There is still this team, 24/7 operational team, and they watch all the alerts. If you provide them instruction how to fix basic problems with your application, they will do it for you. You will not even know. But if the instruction is not there, or it's not working, they will call you in the middle of the night. That's their responsibility. And your responsibility is to fix it. And actually, you will want to fix it. Why? That's your product. That's your baby. You own it. You have all the control, how it should work, how it should look. So you will actually want to fix it. And if you do the product right, it will not fail on weekends. Why would it? Yeah. If you write your product poorly and it blows up in the middle of the weekend, do you really want other people to be responsible for that? You made this mess, yeah? You clean it, yeah? And customer feedback, customer support, this is important. You also need to own this one in DevOps model, but you are not the only one who will be contacting customers. You're not specialized in relations with customers. So you'll get a support from support, customer support team, yeah? They will help you, they will get this feedback for you. And of course, CEO, yeah, minor figure, I'm sure every CEO would like to also have the same vision, but vision for this small piece that you own is yours, and you can only get some guidance from the CEO. And so this is the most important thing about DevOps, yeah? It's about ownership of the whole value stream, and there are other teams that will support you in this, but you own that. So just to summarize, the key takeaways from my perspective are DevOps is about ownership. It's about you owning a piece, you having all the tools, all the rights to develop it the way you think it should be developed, and you own it from the beginning to the end. You own the whole loop. MVP is all about feedback from the customers. Yeah, so based on the customer feedback, you need to evolve your product, and this needs to be constant loop. Scrum is about equality. So there is no individuals in the Scrum team. There is never responsibility on the individual in the Scrum team. The responsibility is always on the team. And members of the team are equal. They are not specialists with their areas of expertise. And microservices, the last one, it's all about independence. So you are not dependent from other teams. You only are responsible for something that you can control. And one digression at the end. Fourth assembly line. Many, many years ago, Ford invented assembly line, as we all know. He made a lot of money because of that. But another interesting thing happened. 10 to 20 years later, all other companies either adopted assembly line or disappeared from the market. That's what happened. Yeah, that was the revolution. Of course, there were this like 1% of companies that survived this, like a niche. Yeah, but 1% is like they are not driving the market. Many years later, Toyota Lean, the same kind of revolution. Toyota, thanks to discovering the lean manufacturing process, become the dominant car producer in the world. And 10, 20 years later, guess what happened? All other manufacturers adopted or disappeared from the market, except this 1% again. Scrum and other agile methodologies, that was the next revolution that happened, this time in IT. Yeah? And we are basically at the end of the Scrum road, in the sense that in 2 years, I really doubt that there will be companies writing software not using Scrum or any agile methodologies. Yeah, waterfall is dead. Yeah, except of this 1%. Yeah, that will still do it old school. And when you look at this, this is iteration. This is evolution. So Toyota Lean evolved from Ford's assembly line. Scrum evolved directly from Lean. And the next thing that's going to happen, that the next step in the evolution is DevOps. And guess what's going to happen in 10, 20 years? All companies will work in a DevOps way, or they will not work at all, except this 1% yes niche. So my call for you is, today there is plenty of specialists in the job market, and only 1% of the companies will still need specialists. So this will be a very competitive market to get a job. So my call to you would be, get on this DevOps train as soon as possible. If you don't know anything about security, learn about security. If you don't know anything about development, learn about development. Become this key person, at least, maybe the comp person in the future. That's where market is heading, and that's the future. Questions?